Welcome to another World of Warplanes tutorial video. Today I'm gonna explain or tell you a bit about the pilot skills and which you should use in the beginning. So if you generate the first points to give away for skills, what kind of points you use for special planes, for example. Alright, normally the big difference between, for example, at fighters, I'm talking about fighters first, is the maneuverability and the speed. For example, the German 109 line, that's this line here, for example, this one here in the middle. This is a line that is really dependent on your airspeed. So you're not as maneuverable than, for example, a Zero or a British Spitfire, which makes it not tough, but the trait is different. So you wanna maximize your speed on this thing, and that is really important because these planes rely on their speed. Of course, they have a kind of decent boost. I think it's 8 seconds. So you dive down, go into this wherever a dogfight is happening or something, dive down, you shoot your guns, and then you always avoid turn fights, especially when there is a mass of planes, or let's call it a cloud of planes, and you dive into, maybe shoot down one or damage one or two planes, then you climb up with boost and try to escape. That's basically what this playstyle is about. So in this plane, or in this line, with these traits, you wanna maximize your speed. And how can you achieve that? First of all, Engine Guru. That's the first perk to go for. I have now Aerodynamics Expert, but that's not so important. First of all, the first 2 points you should invest into Engine Guru 1, and the next 3 points in Engine Guru 2. From there on, you can like go for Aerodynamics Expert, which increases. Let's go over Engine Guru. What it does: increases engine thrust by 3%, significantly improves aircraft acceleration. Acceleration is really important, and the Engine Guru 2 is maximizing this kind of. Aerodynamics is dependent on the modules you use on your plane, but I will go over this maybe in the next. Maybe I can show you the connection. It says it increases the effect of aircraft polish, polish covering, lightweight airframe, control surface adjustment, etc., etc., by 40%, which is a lot. For example, I have engine tuning on my plane here, which gives it 5% more engine power. This one gets increased by 40%. That means that I get 2% more engine power overall. And that's quite significant. It doesn't sound much, but for these planes with this kind of this boom and we call it boom and zoom fighters, this is really important because you can get out of this pretty easy then. Also, this engine tuning helps you a lot if you're flying in higher altitudes. This German fighter line is made for altitude, as you see, optimal altitude 1800 meters, so that's basically high altitude fighter, boom and zoom, you dive from above, etc., what I explained earlier. Alright, so there are also other types of planes. Let's go to the complete opposite. That's, for example, the Zero. The Zero, as you can see, airspeed, pretty low. I mean, it's tier 4, the other one was tier 5. Optimum altitude 600 meters. So everything above that, this plane suffers. So you wanna stay like a bit above or at best below that altitude. And that's the place where you can maximize your advantages. On the other hand, it has a pretty good maneuverability. You see it, 94 is the value. Time to turn 360 degrees, 7 seconds. Let's compare it to the 109. Give me a quick second. There we go. 67, 10. So it's like, that's like between day and night. You can always outmaneuver a 109 in the zero, for example. The zero is on tier 4 zero. There are several zeros in the game. It's the best turn fighter on this tier. So what do you want to do then? All right. Yeah, of course you don't maximize your engine and so on. This is a pretty new captain. I just kept this plane for some missions on the tier 4 stage. So you save your points until you have 3, and then you get evasive target. Evasive target just means that you reduce your damage received and chance of receiving critical damage and pilot injuries by 25% when actively maneuvering. Actively maneuvering, if you have make slow turns or maybe roll and turn and yeah, such stuff. There's always a sound if you are if this is activated, you hear that, and there's also a sign above your plane navigator on the left side, I think. So and that is useful because if you're in a dogfight and with a lot of different planes, then there come this boom and zooms like the 109 from above, dive down to you and try to shoot you down. And of course, if you're like in a turn fight with another fighter, you are like, of course, sometimes you can see it, but sometimes you're not able to. But this reduces the damage by 25%, which can be really valuable. Of course, if you get hit, you should start to outmaneuver or to start maneuver immediately in a different direction. It mitigates the initial damage you get, at least. I mean, if you're like turning all the time and you're in a predictable path, it doesn't help you that much, because then, of course, the plane from above is following your path and shooting exactly that path. And yeah, you receive 25% less damage, but you receive the damage. This is just initially. So you want to break away as soon as you get the damage. You don't receive that much damage initially, but yeah, that helps a lot against this boom and zoom fighters, and that's why I rated really high as a perk. After that, you're kind of free to go whatever you want. You can increase your maneuverability even more with aerobatics expert. That's an option. Marksman 1 to reduce the dispersion on your guns. Yeah, these are not so useful. Yeah. That could be also a thing for planes that have the tendency to often get set on fire. But it's up to you. The basic skill for these fighters are called turn and burn. So boom and zoom, turn and burn. This is definitely mandatory. I would never skip it for anything else. Of course, you can go aerodynamics expert or something, but this video is just about the basic skills, what you are investing in the beginning. From there on, you can this is like as I said, the most important basic skill. It's like priority target on a cruiser in World of Warships. Absolutely mandatory. All right, then you have different lines. For example, the Russians. Let's take this Lavochkin LR5. If you see the statistics, well, it's pretty maneuverable, but it's not as maneuverable as, for example, a Zero. And if you go for speed, it's not as fast as, for example, a 109, but it's decent. But it has also kind of a mid-range altitude performance with of 1,200 meters. So they are like a bit of the jack of all trades. They're not at the best at anything, but they can do everything kind of in a way. So how you want to spec these? Well, since I just started the line, I'm trying it out a bit. But I think I will go first for Engine Guru to increase your engine capabilities and then save 3 points for this evasive target. I think that's a pretty good combination and can work out. Because you're good enough and to fulfill both roles, and that's why I would go this way. But this is of course not settled. You can also increase here this your maneuverability by 2% etc. Also, you want to watch out what the tier 10, if you are aiming for the tier 10, what are the statistics of this line. So let's see the tier 10, and it's almost the same. The airspeed increases massively, so that's why Engine Guru is good. The maneuverability stays the same or is even better, and the altitude performance with 2000 meters is also pretty good. So yeah, this line evolves into a good boom and zoom and really good capable turn fighter as well. So I think you will outmaneuver a lot of planes with a 74 rating. Yeah. And then you have other the Russians are really in between. For example, we have this Yak-9U on tier 7. It has a 45mm gun, so he's, so to say, a sniper. He has also mediocre stats everywhere. Not a really good altitude, not a really good maneuverability, not a really good speed. So, what are you going there for? Yeah, I think I will treat it the same way like I did with the Lavochkin line. I will go also for a evasive target, maybe even marksman, because this 45mm gun is pretty helpful if it gets more accuracy. Or this is not the plane you want to maneuver in too much, so. You want to stay a bit away and don't get into these dogfights, clouds of planes. You want to stay a bit away and use the range of your gun, which is 1,050 meters. So that's a lot. Okay, let's go over to the Americans, because this is a bit tricky. Americans have several lines. I think one real fighter line and two multi-role lines. So the fighters are really fast. So this Mustang here is really fast, as you see. I don't know if I upgraded it to the max yet. I could do it. Give me a sec. So 780 at optimal altitude, and that does not include the how is it called? The boost. Maximum dive speed. So this is, and look at the optimum altitude, 2500 meters. This is exceptionally good. And that means you're like high altitude fire. So I can remember that I was like on 3500 meters with this plane, and it maneuvers still really good. The only weakness this plane has, for example, is they have only machine guns, no machine cannons. And so your alpha is like kind of meh, so to say. And you have to be behind the target a long time. So you're exceptionally good to compete against heavy fighters, because you can easily outmaneuver, you can easily hunt them, or at least most of them. And you can stay behind them, so you can deal damage, enough damage over time. So this is not going to be a disadvantage for you. You want to avoid like fighters that have also good altitude and good maneuverability, because in this case, yeah, you're not bad at maneuvering, but some of these will outmaneuver you, and yeah, you won't be able to shoot them down quick enough. That's why you should also aim in this regard for low HP targets, for example. Pilot, of course, maximizing speed, maneuverability, all this stuff is really important. Also can think of evasive target with this one, because if you fly high altitude and there are heavy fighters, heavy fighters have a huge alpha damage normally because they have a strong armament, and as soon as you get shot at, you break away and receive less damage, which is quite helpful. So this is, I mean, I don't play the game like for ages now, but yeah, for example, that's how I would use them. Okay, here we have a multi-role, an American one. Maneuverability is garbage. Airspeed is decent. I didn't upgrade it to the max yet, but is decent. Altitude is, yeah, I would say average. So how are you going to perform in this line? Well, I maximize the speed, and the next thing I do is, because this plane has a lot of hit points, for example, 480 here. Oh, I could also upgrade this, I just saw. So, oh, twin motor, okay. 525, of course, with this improved covering, that gives me 5% more HP. Yeah, how are you gonna skill these? Well, first of all, the speed is really good for a multi-role, so you can dive really good in this. You have only machine guns, but you have a strong ground pound armament, so that means that you are mostly like initially going for like ground targets. That's why you want to have like some things that are protecting you against ground defensive fire, like from AA. So you could use, for example, hello? What is this skill? Damn it, give me a sec. Why doesn't it show? Yeah, well, this one here, it gives you more safety, but yeah. Normally a thing I would recommend to use on... Oh no, sorry. I wouldn't go for this. I would go for this here. This makes the bomb radius and so on a bit larger and more effective, because you're more of a like kind of ground attacker fighter thing. I mean, you're still a multi-role, but you have this one. This line has pretty good ground pound capabilities. The same like this Corsair F2G, also really good ground pound capabilities, so you want to maximize after the speed your bomb radius, etc, and bomb damage. So that's it for multi-rolls. There are German multi-rolls I would go the same way, like this premium plane, the 109 A8, full speed, and then expand your ground pound capabilities by making your bombs more effective. Alright, heavy fighters. Also the same. They are like the huge boom and zoomers, especially the German ones. High altitude, great speed, good armament, some ground pound capabilities. So also a thing where you can debate over, or debate that maybe also increase the bombs. Also, you could go for this, I don't know how this skill is called. Give me a sec, because I used it here. So here it is, Protection Expert. Improved covering, reinforced airframe and ATC, additional armor plates, it all gets buffed. That's, by the way, a ground attacker. And Yeah, that's also an option. But the first things should be all invested in speed, for example. The British ground heavy fighters also speed, but I definitely will go for demolition expert next. They are not as fast as the German ones, so but they have a strong ground pound armament, as you see, two bombs, a lot of rockets, and 240 mm on this tier 8 one. So you want to maximize this as well. And that's how you go through the lines. I mean, we have here also a Japanese key line. That's the this line here. They are still the best turn fighters, because the zero line stops at tier 7 and then it goes over to a multi-role line. And the key line is having a good altitude performance. It has a good, the best, I think, the best maneuverability, a really good airspeed, and yeah, the only thing it's lacking is the survivability, but that's a Japanese thing. And therefore, I went for evasive target first, and then engine guru, and then you can. I would go for engine guru too, and maybe even that one firefighter, because these Japanese planes and Russian ones are tending to get to catch fire. All right, so what do we have next? Ground attackers, yeah. Ground attackers, I would spec in the first place like bombers. You go for, first of all, protection expert, and then demolition expert. Then you can go expert rocketeer. Oh no, that's maybe not so important because it's just relating to aircraft. What can you use here more? Attack aircraft all and bombers should be all about survivability. If you come to the rear gunner, first perk should be defensive fire to mitigate damage that you receive, and the next one should be precision gunner, so your gunner is taking out vulnerable sections like the engine on enemy planes that are attacking you. Bombers here, you see it, almost the same. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't want to go too deep into it because I don't have too many planes with too many pilots with too many skill points either, so that might take a while. But overall, that I think I just showed you the basics. Of course, you can vary things in your own style if you want to, but normally I would go for build up the strengths of your planes even more. Like if it has a good speed, then increase the speed even more. If it has good maneuverability, then increase the maneuverability. In the end, it's of course up to you. It's not so expensive to respec a pilot, but yeah, I think there are some mandatory skills for some classes. Spitfire, for example, also evasive, and then engine guru, because it's decently fast and also pretty good maneuverability. So yeah. All right, I hope that helped you figuring out how to spec. If you have a certain question to a certain plane, just leave it in the comments. Next one will be, our next tutorial video will be about the modules, what are they giving you and which you should use on certain planes. Yeah, I will go into that the next time. All right, bye bye and have a good day.